Hello dear students, welcome to the lecture series of object oriented programming. In this lecture we are going to see how to resolve the ambiguity in multiple as well as in the single inheritance. At the end of this lecture you will be able to resolve ambiguity in single and multiple inheritance. Let us first see how the ambiguity occurs in multiple inheritance. As you know that in multiple inheritance, a single class may inherit the properties from more than one base classes. Then we may face the problem using this type of inheritance when function with the same name appears in multiple base classes. Let us see the example over here. For example, I have class M and I have one more class as a class N. These two of the classes are going to work as a base classes for our derived class. Now if you observe here, I have a function for my class M which says it is a void display function and which is displaying the statement as a class M on the screen. And here I have another class that is class N which has the same function name that is void display and which is going to display the statement as class N on the screen. Now if you observe these two of the classes, their function definition is different but the name of that function is same. Okay, now let us consider one more class. Let us consider class P, which is a derived class, and that class P is going to inherit the properties from class M and class N. Okay, now when that class P wants to call or evoke the display function, okay, then which display function should be evoked? Whether the display function which belongs to class M should be evoked or the display function which belongs to class N should evoke. Okay, now here the ambiguity has occurred. Now let us see how to resolve this ambiguity. We can resolve this ambiguity by defining a named instance within the derived class using this class resolution operator with the function. Now let us see the example. As I told you, let us consider a class P which is our child class, and that child class is inheriting the properties from class M and class N. Now as we have seen that class M and class N consist of the function name void display, which is same for both of the functions. And now if class P wants to inherit or call that void display, then ambiguity will occur. So how to resolve that ambiguity? We can use the name of a class followed by this class scope resolution operator, or you can say the class resolution operator. Okay, now if you write in this manner, then what will happen? This statement will tell the compiler that this display function belongs to class M. Okay, and in that case the class M, that statement will be displayed on the screen. Okay, so in that manner we can resolve the ambiguity which occurs in the multiple inheritance. How to resolve? We have to write a name of a class, name of a base class, followed by the scope resolution operator, followed by the name of the function. Okay, and that will indicate that this function belongs to that respective class. Okay, so in that case the multiple ambiguity will be resolved in the multiple inheritance. Now let us see how the ambiguity has been resolved in the single inheritance. Now let us see first how the ambiguity occurs in the single inheritance. Ambiguity occurs in the single inheritance when you have the same function name in your base class as well as in your derived class. Now please observe the example over here. Here I have class A and I have one more class as a class B. Class A is my base class and class B is my derived class or the child class. Now class B wants to inherit the properties from class A. Class A has a function as a void display which is displaying the class A statement on the screen, and in the same case class B is also has the function as void display and which is displaying the statement as a class B on the screen. Now if you observe here, the definitions are different but the name of those functions are same. The name of the function in the base class as well as in the derived class is same. Now how to resolve this ambiguity? So there are different ways to resolve such type of ambiguity. Let us see those different ways. Now the first way is we can resolve this ambiguity, that means we can evoke the function which belongs to class B, okay, using simply by creating a object which belongs to class B, and of course that the simple call display by B type object will evoke the function defined in the B only, okay. And if we have the same function name in class A, that is our base class, and in class B, that is our derived class, then the function in the derived class overrides the inherited function, okay. We have learned in unit number 2, that is polymorphic class hierarchy, okay. And we have also seen the function overriding concept theoretically, okay. So in that case, the function which is there in the derived class, it overrides the inherited function, okay. It overrides the function which is inherited by the derived class from the base class, okay. So function overriding may be the solution for that ambiguity resolution, okay. And the second case, as I told you, we can simply call that display function by B type object. That means we can create an object which is created from class B, and we can simply call that display function using that object and dot operator, okay. So in that case, the definition of the function which belongs to class B will be evoke, okay. And one more solution we have, that we may evoke the function defined by A by using the scope resolution operator to specify the class. Now let us see with example how it can be done. Now for example, here I have object 2 which is created from class B. Now when I write object 2 dot display, then in that case this statement will evoke the display function which belongs to class B, which is available in class B, okay. And if you want that display function in class A should be evoked, then in that case you can write obj.a followed by scope resolution operator followed by the name of a function. Now if you observe here, this statement indicates that this function display belongs to class A, okay. And of course that function will be called using the object of class B, okay, because class B is inheriting the properties from class A, okay. So that using the obj, that is object 2 dot, that is dot operator followed by the name of a base class followed by scope resolution operator followed by name of that function. So this will indicate that this statement indicates that this display function belongs to class A, okay. And now if you want to call that display function which belongs to class B, you can write in this manner also. The first way is this, and this is the second way. You can write obj2.b followed by scope resolution operator followed by the name of the function, okay. So in that case also, the function display which belongs to class B will be evoked. So likewise, we can resolve the ambiguity in single and multiple inheritance. I hope you have understood. So we will meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Happy learning.